Greetings once and once. Yes, I do hope that you are doing well. Welcome to our new program, a special program by the name The Mass. Yes, The Mass. And today we will have a special guest in the building who is going to introduce himself in a minute. But before that, we would like to give thanks to some of the facilitators. First, we have to give thanks for the contribution and facilitation of the Boom Shoot Media for making things happen. We also want to give thanks to the Kushai Bongo program and also Rastaman for providing this space where this interview is being taken care of. Yes, Elder.
Yes, sir.
Would you please tell I and I, the viewers, who are we talking to? Who are we talking to, generally? Your background.
See.
Why are we here and here in Tanzania per se, and all other things about you? Please, yes, go on.
Rastafari.
Selassie.
My name is Muhemsi Mwakihwelo.
Yes.
Come from outside Birmingham, England.
Yes.
My family originates in Jamaica, so seven of my brothers and sisters have come from Jamaica.
Okay.
And three have also born in England. I and my two younger sisters.
Okay.
So basically grew up in a Jamaican family in England. You see?
Yeah.
All right.
Okay, give thanks for that. So you have a multiple heritage there. Yeah, that I can see. An African with multiple extra heritage within you. So most of the viewers will confidently say that, yeah, the man is speaking with the Rastaman. Yes. So could you tell us what were the forces behind your decision tagging or subscribing to the Rastafari movement? Why not other kinds of movements? Why not other kinds of life? Why not other kinds of ideologies but Rastafari? What was the motive behind that?
See,
yes, sir.
As I mentioned, I was born in England.
Yes.
England is seen as Britain, Great Britain as I'm called it.
Mm-hmm.
It's seen as the mother country.
Yeah.
Right? Because when they take an eye out of Africa,
yeah,
seeing they brought an eye down into the Americas, Jamaica, the Caribbean,
yeah,
and worked an eye as slave on the plantation.
Mm-hmm.
Right, so Rastafari philosophy sees Africa as Zion.
Mm-hmm.
And I were taken as Babylon.
Okay.
Coming from the Bible.
Okay.
Because as Jomo Kenyatta stated, when the colonizers came to Africa.
Eh?
Yes.
They
Africans are the land.
Mm-hmm.
They are the Bible,
the Bible
and Africans,
yes,
are the land.
Yeah, yeah.
And them teach the Africans to pray.
Yeah.
And when them open them eyes,
mm-hmm,
the Africans are the Bible,
and
the colonizers, the Europeans, are the land.
Okay.
Yeah, so they give you the Bible.
Mm-hmm.
Right, they give I and I the Bible to subjugate I and I.
Mm-hmm.
You understand?
Yes, sir.
To pacify,
mm-hmm,
I and I.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, telling I and I of some God in the sky.
Mm-hmm.
You over?
Yeah.
So I and I was brought up as Christian, Baptist.
Oh, Baptist Christian.
Yeah, so my father and mother, they were Baptists, or they are Baptists.
Mm-hmm.
And so I and I went to Baptist
church. Yeah.
Yeah? So them tell me about Jesus and all these things.
White Jesus.
Yes,
mm-hmm,
right? And the preacher man, the church full of black people, but the preacher man's a white man.
It's a white man, yeah.
Right? So what I get to realize is that when they're talking about equality, that you know, I and I are equal.
It's as a human really, being.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
It's not so. Them treat black people different.
Different, yes.
Right,
yes.
So in England, them discriminate against us.
Okay.
Yes, discriminate against I and I. You know? So that is what I and I experience in school, discrimination. The parents in the workplace, discrimination.
The right? Streets.
Yes, discrimination. You know, so they told us that the streets of England was paved with gold, but when I and I parents came, they buckled up on discrimination.
Okay.
Right? Mm. So sometimes you couldn't get work. And you couldn't get a place to live, because their philosophy was no blacks, no Irish, no dogs.
No black?
No blacks.
Mm-hmm.
That means it's when you went to go and get a room to stay, a house to live in.
Yeah, yeah.
In the window they had a sign that they don't rent to blacks.
To blacks, Oh, so just like in America, where was the whites only, black only, like in South Africa in apartheid times?
Yes.
Okay.
That's in England, they call it a color bar.
Oh, color bar.
Yeah.
So color included black people?
Black people.
Okay.
So they say blacks.
Mm-hmm.
Also, they have the Irish.
Okay.
So in Europe, in Britain, they discriminated against the Irish people.
Oh.
Yeah.
So the Irish also, they are not such white.
They're white.
Uh-huh.
But they discriminated against them.
Oh, okay.
Yeah?
Okay.
Right? And then you have, then they say no dogs.
No dogs.
Yeah, so you can't, if you have a dog, you can't get that room.
Oh.
Yeah? So they're not renting out to you. So we face discrimination, so we have to look into ourselves and get our identity.
Okay.
Yeah? Because when we're in the school playground, they tell I and I, mm-hmm. or tell us, go back to your own country.
Okay.
Yeah, but we were born in England, so this is our country.
Okay, but you felt that that was not your country.
No.
And in reality, you know that you came out somewhere.
From somewhere
from
else.
Somewhere else, yeah.
So when we trace, our parents came from Jamaica.
Okay.
Yeah, but their four parents came from Africa.
Yeah, yeah.
So I originated in Africa.
Mm-hmm.
See? So that is how I trace it forward.
Okay, okay.
Yeah, to Africa.